Let's get back to the renewables versus nuclear power debate. We've spoken plenty of times with entrepreneur Dick Smith. He's taken out an ad in the Australian newspaper today. Our Prime Minister and Minister for Energy, Chris Bowen, have been misled by the CSIRO and the Australian Energy Market Operator, he says. No other country has or is planning to operate their energy system entirely on wind, solar and storage. Expect blackouts. I'm pro-renewables, he says, but there is no need to destroy the environment to save the environment. Dick Smith joins me again in the studio. Congratulations on taking out that ad. You must be frustrated by the argument then that some of these salient points are not being made clearly enough.
Yeah, it's very, very frustrating. What people are not looking at is the damage to the environment with the thousands of wind farms. And, of course, there's no battery storage provided with the wind farms because if you did that, you couldn't afford the power. And so what I'm trying to point out to the Prime Minister and to the Minister for Energy that wind farms, OK, but they're intermittent. Put some batteries with them and then you can't afford the power.
Yeah, this is the problem, isn't it? Now, when you talk about the environmental damage, we've spoken often to Stephen Nowakowski from Queensland. I'll show you some vision here where he's shown how wind farms along the Great Dividing Range in Queensland are taking out huge roads being put into virgin bushland. And this is a graphic he's done up showing where all these wind farms are going in. But each one of them, you have roads through bushland and then a huge area cleared to put in the base of the wind farm. And we're seeing this damage now, Dick. The point is to meet this target of 82% renewable, every wind farm or wind turbine you see now, you've got to multiply that by eight or 10.
And it's interesting, I've just done a drive out to Birdsville and then down to Adelaide and then across. We passed wind farms on the way and they're all sitting dead still. You might have noticed in June we had lots of high-pressure systems sitting over New South Wales, Victoria. So no wind, so no power. So you'd not need 3 hours of storage, which I think the CSIRO have allowed for. You'd need 3 days or maybe longer.
Yeah, well, this is the problem, isn't it? Now, you talk about nuclear as an option. Nuclear power is very dense. You have a power station, it can be built where there is already transmission lines and a lot of energy produced in one small location with a small amount of waste and fuel really going into it, whereas renewable energy is the opposite. It's so sparse, it's going to take out so much land and coastline.
Yeah, and look, the Prime Minister's saying nuclear is too expensive for Australia. You've got to be joking. Pakistan and Bangladesh have embraced nuclear. Now, they are really poor countries. They're trying to tell me that they can afford nuclear, but we can't. I mean, to me, nuclear is the gold standard for baseload power, and we actually have to have it.
So to sum up your position, you're saying nuclear is the better option for the environment.
Definitely. You won't have to destroy the environment to save the environment. Pretty important.
Yeah, it is vital. Now, the other aspect of this, though, that I think is absolutely telling and the opposition coalition need to get onto this strongly, and that is no matter what nuclear costs or how long it takes, we know it works. You mentioned Bangladesh and Pakistan. We can talk about France, Finland, South Korea, the UK.
Yeah. 30 countries.
Very, very successful economies. We know it works and we know it provides reliable power. But the model the government is trying to put into place, basically solely reliant on renewables and storage, has not occurred in any other country.
Nowhere in the world. Because
and a lot of engineers tell us it can't happen.
It can't. Common sense says you're not going to be able to do that. It's too intermittent. It's interesting. I bought a car, a Nissan Leaf, and I wanted it to be battery operated from the sun. So I bought this huge battery for the garage. That worked for 10 years. Then the Nissan Leaf battery had to be replaced at $10,000. Now my big battery in the garage is going to be $40,000 to replace it. So it worked out that my Nissan Leaf being powered from the sun costs twice as much per kilometre than a petrol Leaf. So, in effect, if you want to go renewables, you have to be wealthy.
Yeah. Well, look at it this way. When I talk to all sorts of engineers away from politics, they talk about an electrical system where you have to have baseload power. 30 or 40% of power that's there 24/7, absolutely when you need it, completely reliable. That used to be coal. in the future it could be nuclear. Then on top of that, you would have a lot of solar and renewable, including domestic on people's houses and factory. But and on top of that, you would still need gas peaking for when there's high demand or when there's a wind drought or the like, you kick in with gas. So are they the three sources we will end up with in this country?
Yeah, definitely. Look, one day, just as Labor changed its view 180 degrees on nuclear submarines, I was told by friends when I ran ads in The Australian for the nuclear subs, I was told, Dick, Labor will never change their mind, you're wasting your money. Then I woke up one morning and what had happened, the coalition decided on nuclear subs and wait for it, Labor reversed 180 degrees and supported it. Now, they'll have to do the same with nuclear power. The longer they delay, the worse it is for our young people.
I think you're right. I think nuclear power is inevitable for Australia, and I think all the logic points to that, all the logic and all the science points to that. So the longer we delay, the more we're going to hurt people now. Are you disappointed to see so much partisan politics around it, given really it's only a question of engineering and economics and the environment?
I'm very disappointed with the conservation organisations and the Greens. You'd think they would be objecting to this incredible destruction of the environment and saying, no, we're not going to put up with that. They say nothing, but they're against nuclear, where you can just have 5 acres of a nuclear power station instead of thousands of square miles being destroyed.
That is bizarre. When you look at all those wind turbines going up the coast, as we've just seen, and they're going to be floating offshore as well. If they were mobile phone towers or something else, every green group in the country would be opposing them and protesting against them. But now they're just turning a blind eye to them.
And as I put in my ad, what they should do to the wind farms is say you have to provide battery storage so you can supply power 24/7. Now, they don't do that because you wouldn't be able to afford the power.